the first weekend of the NCAA tournament radically reshaped the pack of national championship contenders. Half of this year's number 1, number 2 and no. 3 seeds were eliminated, only one no. 4 seed remains, and a pair of number 7, number 9 and number 11 seeds advanced. 5 of the 10 teams SI.com pegged before the tourney as most likely to win it all will be forced to watch the remaining rounds from their couches. Before the Sweet 16 tips off on Thursday, we're running the same exercise with every squad left in the field. 1 Villanova, no. 1 seed East, as high major heavyweights bowed out left and right over the first 4 days of the NCAAs, Villanova made quick work of its first 2 opponents to move on to the second weekend. After throttling number 16 seed Radford in the round of 64, the Wildcats bombarded no. 9 seed Alabama and its sturdy defense, 18th in Ken Pomeroy's adjusted efficiency, with 17 three-pointers. This has the potential to turn into the type of searing shooting run that propelled Villanova to the program's second national title 2 years ago. The Wildcats' season guards won't be fazed by no. 5 seed West Virginia's press on Friday, 2. Michigan, number 3 seed, West. The Wolverines had a close call against Houston on Saturday. A freshman who'd made only one of his previous 10 three-point attempts heading into the round of 32 rescued them with a deep buzzer-beating tray that temporarily turned 65-year-old head coach John Beilein into a 10-year-old at the neighborhood pool party. "Sorry, couldn't help myself. Michigan didn't shoot the ball well from deep overall against the Cougars, 8 of 30, but it still managed to hold Rob Gray below a point per possession." The Wolverines' defensive strength gives them a bigger margin of error than they've typically had during Beilein's tenure in the event their offense dries up. 3 Kentucky, no. 5 seed, South. The biggest reason the Wildcats' national title chances look so good right now isn't directly related to their play. It's the mayhem that shook the South region during the tourney's opening weekend. Number 4 seed Arizona was upset by number 13 seed Buffalo. Number 11 seed Loyola Chicago downed both number 6 seed Miami and number 3 seed Tennessee. And, most unexpectedly, number 1 seed Virginia was bulldozed by number 16 seed UMBC. When the dust settled, Kentucky was the highest seed remaining in this quadrant of the bracket. Next up for the Wildcats is a meeting with middle-tier Big 12 squad Kansas State. 4 Duke, number 2 seed, Midwest. The college hoops world was eagerly anticipating a potential matchup between the Blue Devils and 3rd-seeded Michigan State in the Sweet 16. Instead, Syracuse tripped up the Spartans in the second round to set up a meeting between the team with a higher ceiling than any other in the bracket and a no. 11 seed that arguably didn't deserve to get in. Duke is familiar with the Orange's 2-3 zone, and it beat them by 16 in Cameron Indoor Stadium less than a month ago. A potential game against number 1 seed Kansas in the Elite 8 looms if the Blue Devils can notch a similar result against Syracuse on Friday. 5 Kansas, number 1 seed, Midwest. The Jayhawks' path to San Antonio is manageable in the short term. All they need to do to get to the Elite 8 is handle a Clemson team that ranked 11th in the ACC offensively on a per-possession basis during conference play. Things get more challenging after that, with Duke likely standing between Kansas and its first Final Four appearance in 6 years. The good news for the Jayhawks is that sophomore big man Udoka Azubuike is making progress recovering from the knee injury that sidelined him for the Big 12 tournament and limited him to only 3 minutes in the first round win over Penn. Azubuike logged 22 minutes against Seton Hall on Saturday. 6 Texas Tech, no. 3 seed East, the Red Raiders sputtered toward the end of the regular season, dropping 4 consecutive games against Baylor, Oklahoma State, Kansas and West Virginia before a March 3rd win over TCU, as senior point guard Keenan Evans nursed a toe injury. If the toe is still bothering Evans, it didn't prevent him from lifting Texas Tech into the Sweet 16 by combining to score 45 points on 58.3% shooting in wins against No. 14 seed Stephen F. Austin and number 6 seed Florida over the weekend. With Evans operating at the peak of his powers, the Red Raiders could well be the strongest team from the nation's most challenging conference. 7. Gonzaga, no. 4 seed, West. A year after reaching the national title game on the strength of a veteran-heavy lineup, the Zags have ridden a group of talented underclassmen to their 4th Sweet 16 in a row. Redshirt freshman Zach Norville Jr. was the hero in Saturday's 92-84 conquest of Ohio State, connecting on 6 of his 11 three-point tries in a 28-point showing. If his shots aren't falling, Gonzaga can turn to one of 2 promising sophomore forwards, 6 feet 8 inches Rui Hachimura and 6 feet 10 inches Killian Tilly. The Zags are one of only two teams left in the bracket that rank in the top 15 if Pomeroy's adjusted offensive and defensive efficiency. Duke is the other one, 8. Purdue, no. To seed East, whether or not Mammoth center Isaac Haas makes a miraculous return to the court after fracturing his right elbow in Friday's opening round win over Cal State Fullerton, the Boilermakers have enough offensive firepower to compromise Texas Tech's stout defense, which ranks fourth in Pomeroy's adjusted efficiency.